Hi guys, out again. Had a hell of a time to find a place because I usually go like 20 clicks from home and it was raining. It was kind of the weather we had like 2 or 3 hours ago. And then there's people everywhere, mushroom pluckers. So I marked a few places on my Google Maps and I thought I'd continue and just drive around back again another way. So and then I found this. Looks okay, and the rain's stopped, and it's actually not that cold either. It's been we had like 19 degrees at home. When I come to the forest, it was like 18. Went down to 17. And yeah, not a good day. Trying on the bow quiver again. I'm gonna show you. I got like 3 stumps. I got 3 there actually. But we have one. Let me see that. Behind there. There's one. Trying to hide, eh? So, first shot of today. I wonder if there's a rock on the right side or another stump. Let's put it right there in the middle of that stump, eh? Right there. Ooh, whoa, man, I love that. I mean, back in the days, over 30 years ago now, the first 10 years I was stumping, man, I was like hoping to hit something with the first arrow. Now I'm just hitting the spot, man. It's so amazing, man. It's fantastic. It's like having a rifle with a scope, man. This is insane. It's so easy. I could have dreamed of maybe hitting one of those stumps 30 years ago. No, 20 years ago, 25. It really is ridiculously easy nowadays, and all I have to do is be above the arrow, man. One thing though is, man, oh, look at that stump. That's like Gray's dream, right? Fantastic. That's a corpse mushroom. Well, at least it looks like one. So, very nice stump so far. And this quiver actually works. Doesn't seem to move my arrows to the right, so. But actually, I shot with bow quivers before, but that was kind of before the solution above the arrow thing. So I was a bit, I wasn't there, I was like here, man. So I just wonder, is that not an issue anymore? Because I'm holding the bow quite firmly. I don't have a loose compound grip on an Olympic recurve grip. I have a traditional grip, so to speak. So let's continue, guys. So actually, I don't think it matters what I put on the bow, as long as I hold the handle still and be above the arrow. Man, there's some big stumpies here. Why I marked this place is that there is some beech tree forests a bit from here. I thought I gotta drive down here and take right here. But it's a bit shitty weather today. I don't feel like it. I've just been driving around looking at that stream that goes by here. It's absolutely fantastic. It is a, I don't know if it is the Susan or a smaller portion of it floating down through the sewer, but it is absolutely magically beautiful. And that stump is huge, man. I could throw a knife from here. Let's not do that. I just thought I'd walk down this road and look how it looks like. Seems like there's actually another forest behind there that looks to be a bit open, stumpy like, you know. I was hoping the moose flies haven't got out yet. Doesn't seem like it. It's been a bit hot. Yesterday was insane, man. I was driving bus 6 hours. It was like 26, 27 degrees, man. What? And today it's like, what, 19. Oh, I have a couple of, oh, that's a big one, just right away. Rock. Well, I do like a challenge, don't I? But that's, what, 50 so on yards, meters, maybe 50 away. I could actually hide that rock behind the tree trunk there, because I got one in the foreground here. I don't know, foreground is there? There's like two there. Let's try that. Let's take the first one. I mean, that also is like 40 meters away, so. And I think there's a lot of rocks here, so. Don't miss, Gray. Oh, God, I love this, man. And that far away stump. You're kidding me, man. That flew like winged bird. Bad release, but it still went there. That's insane, guys. So, we probably have the wettest year so far, I don't know, in history, man, because I thought the winter was, it was tough, because it was such a crappy weather, man, so. Now the summer's been like the wettest so far, I think, in history, at least in my time, so. That's the thing. What is this? Little mushies. Fungus, man. Are these the crazy mushrooms? You're kidding me, all over. The forests down here are absolutely infested with mushrooms, so I understand people coming here to pluck them, because I need a new foam inside of my quiver, because this kind of doesn't hold the arrows anymore. I just can't find anything. I need this dense gray or black one, but it doesn't seem to have that, so. So what I understand, if I go up that road there, it's gonna be kind of a, it looks like it is a beech tree, but it's not certain. It could be something else. I know the word for that tree, but it's rock hard, man. And this green carpet, man. Fantastic to walk on. We have a nice stream here. Let's go down and check it out. Oh, you gotta be kidding. That is a nice stump. That is a really nice stump, guys. Full of rocks. And probably fine by the way. There's somebody been here. Probably with a dirt bike, what do you think? So how are you guys doing? Mike? Mr. Cooper? Blaine, how you doing? Hope everything is alright. I don't know what end of the US you live in. You still have summer or is autumn closing by? Seems to come from not only here but from above, floating down to the small river. Hey man, that's kind of a uphill there, but it looks manageable even though I don't have a four-wheel drive. So yeah, this actually is a good start. If it were a fine day, I could actually probably go in there and just shoot my way up there. I already wasted like 1.5 hours, so my spouse is gonna put out an APB on me, or what it's called. Soon. Actually looks very nice here. It's this green carpet, it's fantastic. It's actually a very good place to park my car actually, yeah. I just remembered or thought of it. Did I lock my car? I don't know, man. You try that trick that when you're a bit too far away from your car and this doesn't work, you put this against your forehead and push the button and it works. It's insane, man. It magnifies the range of this signal. I mean, like 2-3 times longer. It's absolutely crazy, but the brain is full of liquid. It seems like that is kind of amplifying the signal. Huh? A bit downhill shooting would be nice. Yep, I got something there. Why don't the big one? Just two smaller ones. See if I can put this one down. There's a couple of there. Yep. The grey ones. Close shots. At least for being me. Oh, that was a rock hard. Why? Man is in the open. The other one behind. Oh, that was nice. That was like perfect, man. Here they are there. Is this the psychedelic mushroom, guys? I've never seen so many. It's insane. And this. Whoa, this is wetlands. Damn. I don't know if I dare to go over there. I don't. That's a small little creek. And there's so much moss, so I don't see where it kind of do that so well. I should have looked at that before I took the shots. Hope that arrow is okay, because hey, that looks like it's spongy soft. Yeah, it is. on the outside. So I'm gonna close this for. So the stumping hermit I found was, oh man, you see that? But that is the wet creek going there. Shit. No, I was about to get there last time, and as soon as I arrived, I was still sitting in the car, putting away some phone and stuff, and two cars coming really fast, full of women and children. You know, I've been through that before. They have a trail cam, and that's just to kind of protect their land, even though it's not legal, because if you're filming people, you need a license. So they kind of use these trail cams, and then they quickly, as they get over there and scare the people away. Because what makes me wonder are they like hiding something, or why? I mean, especially now when the mushrooms pickers everywhere. So I thought, okay, I marked enough, a lot of other places, let's go there instead. I found that, as you saw. And I just continue on this road, kind of, forwards, and a lot of places to go. So, okay, let's take that big one. Oh, so noise. It landed, I think, in the hole, man. That is so insane, man. So, first film I did, I had wrong glasses on. And last film I did, I had the right glasses on. You saw, I hit that like, 1/4 of an inch thingy at 50 meters. Man, that's insane. But it is so, so, so important to see that smaller stuff. Otherwise, you're not going to hit it. You're not going to get close, because not only see the small things, you need to focus on the small things. So I bet you there are guys out there think they see good, but they don't, and that is what is kind of keeping them from shooting good. Let's shoot. I see like they're like, oh, how many? Oh, there's a lot of them. Is that so? Oh, that's a rock and roll. So that's even one on the left side there. Let's make holes in them. So it's so incredibly important to see the smallest thing. Of course, the brain needs to focus on that to kind of steer the arrow, put it right on a path against it, using your eyes. So it's very, very important. Also important that you take the time to focus. Oh man, it does everything, man. And actually, these glasses are getting a bit old, so I could use another newer pair with kind of a better focus, because, okay, I would say they're like 98%, and give it a few months and it's like 95%. It goes fast. That far away there, can we hit that? Oh no. And I only have 3 arrows, but that was actually my idea here. Just taking 3 with me, because my car is not that far away, and just to kind of, well, not overstressing my shoulder, man. I was about to put them in the quiver that I don't have. Damn. You get used to things, eh? made so many holes in this quiver, in the foam, so there's nothing left. Oh man, that's like a meter left, but you see sideways, it's spot on. That is mostly what this solution thing is doing. It is kind of eliminating the sideways shooting completely. So you're like halfway there, man. It's just getting in those yardages in your head. So repetition, repetition. So let's try that. Key fob thing. I don't know if you see that car, but it doesn't work from here. I'll put it on my forehead and it works. It's so sick. First time someone said that to me, I thought they were joking, man. Yeah, you're full of crap, but it actually works real good too. So, holy smoke, that is the grumpy, the nice one. Hey, shit, that is a... Oh no, man. Oh no, man. I think I got a moose fucking fly in my ear. Is it still there? He landed on my ear. Probably went into my hair, man. Shit. I heard it thump. They're sitting in this tree. I think they're coming out from these trees. Let's take that. That's insanely far away, but hey, why not? Just have fun. I got 3 arrows, man. So over there. Over there. Can I put at least one of them there? Because this is, I'm kidding you not. Damn, man, that's gotta be like 65 meters away. And after this time, not shooting anything, I don't have anything in my brain. So I really need to use the staring bit here. Ugly owl staring, looking around it, trying, giving the brain a chance to estimate the yardage, man. But it goes down from 1/3 of the yardage over, and then it goes down. Oh shit, that's even more difficult. So, but it's lower down than I'm standing, so the arrow's path arc is going to help. But hey, I want to hit it with the first one, otherwise it doesn't really count, does it? So. It doesn't count. Man, it's far away. Shit, looked, felt like the arrow was pointing up in the forest somewhere. Man. There it is. I wonder my brain said, shit, sorry. I know. I think I was right. Then I just let my left arm down. Have a lot of excuses, don't we, archers? But the good thing, main thing is, if you know what you're doing wrong, man, if you know what you're doing wrong, you can correct it. Yes. Okay, that wasn't that far away, the first one, but still. Did not hit it, did I? Bam, bam, bam. So, okay. Yeah, I understand, completely stupid shot to take so far away, but hey, man, I do this for fun. And for fun, there ain't anything called stupid. Everything is just fun. I wonder if I got a moose fly in my under my cap. If they're already here, man, that's kind of end of my season, because shit. Cars are going by. That's also so far away. Now, if I overshoot there, no way I'm gonna find that. So yeah, actually very nice. I just think I'm gonna go up that road and see how it looks. If that is a beech tree forest, that is going to be the best ever. So I have a new favorite place. Damn, next season. What? I didn't put my bow correctly on my hook, so I probably showed you my registration number, but hey, I don't give a shit. I did that with the old one. But so guys, let's come up and see. Okay, so looking very good, except there are not that many stumps here. I just went in there. Huge hill. I actually had to gather some speed to get up there, man. But oh, that was a nice one. But it seems like it actually is what I thought it is. But these are not. Yeah, it is beech trees. Except in the canopy, I can see that. But man, it looks good. But not that many stumps. They usually are not that many, but they are big and they are kind of very, they're soft like paper. See that hill, man, that's serious shit. So yep, that canopy, those trees, leaves looks like beech. It's a long time since I've been in a beech forest now. And yeah, I definitely have to come over here to check this out. But so do I need to get some speed up here? I think so, because it's gravel. So okay, this wasn't the big one. Oh no, don't do that. So yeah, and there is the rock heaven, right? That looks insane. So this is the first hill up, but yeah, good times ahead. It's very walkable, open forest, easy to walk there. And as I thought, I could actually, as I said before, I could, just before the stream here, go over there and just continue up shooting my way up to that beech tree forest. So yep, that's gonna be awesome, guys. That is gonna be good. Ah, I love it. But I'm like, what, 335 clicks from home? It's a bit too far, to be honest. Not gonna be here that often. It's gonna a lot of petrol, but hey, Mr. Cooper, he gave me some petrol money through my PayPal, and I'm using that. So I need to order some new Swiki Judos too for the next season. And shit, so what is that about that moose fly? Do I have that in my hair? I should kind of, let's stop here and see if I can feel him. They're trying to hide in the hair and suck me blood, those bastards. But I grabbed my ear just when he landed, so I hope I pushed him away when he still had his wings on. So doesn't seem like I have anything what I can feel, but let's see if something moves when I'm driving home. So guys, that was that. Another great little short stumping season, right? Session. So until next time, guys, I'll see you in the forest, right? So just like 150 meters down, man. A beautiful stream, and it really looks like there should be some brown trout here, man. But there's normally not that much water. We have had a big flood, I think it's called, because it's been raining like never before, man. It's been crazy, but that is absolutely fantastic. It looks like up in the north, man, in the hills where I lived before. There were places I fished looked like this. So yeah, the flood has been extreme. But what a nice place, eh? I wonder if there is any brown trout here. You know, I got this 7.6 foot four weight. So guys, take care, and I'll see you up there in the forest, right?